Alright guys, so we're out here doing a little fly fishing on the Guadalupe River. I don't even know if anything's gonna bite today. But yeah, we're out here. I got a little fly out there, chartreuse. It's a top water. This is my first time fly fishing. So let's see what we got. I ended up going buying this one at the Bass Pro Shop. I forgot the name of the White River Bighorn. 9 foot, 5 weight, 4 piece. So that's what I'm using. So let's see what we could get into. So what I'm doing, I'm casting upriver. I'm just letting it sink down. There we go. I gotta get my casting down so I could be able to get it out further, but this should be good for now. Got wrapped up a little. Maybe I need more. I'm going more so it could go further. Starting to get a little bit of rain here. That one did go a little further. I don't know how much line to mend out. But we're just gonna let it go. Trying to come down, so I might have to. Get a little bit of rain here. Let's just keep doing what we're doing. As long as we don't see no lightning, we should be good. I have to add a split shot to this guy.
Oh. Red line.
How's it going, man?
Alright?
Yes, sir. Yeah, it is. Yeah. I'm surprised there's nobody out here.
Well, because the Parks and Wildlife, they came out last week and said that was their last Friday to stock fish.
Uh-huh.
So when they don't stock them, like the majority of people that come here watch that stocking schedule and they want to be here like when they release
them. Yeah.
But the thing about it is, man, there's so many people when that's happening.
Yeah, I know. I've been out here a couple times when they stock it. And we're all throwing into the same spot. So, yeah. Yeah.
It's pretty cool right now, man. Springs are flowing down.
Yeah, I saw the spring as I was coming in also.
It's kicking in right after Waco Falls here, and it's stirring that area up pretty good.
Okay.
Definitely worth fishing it.
Where's that? Right down over there?
Just past the last RV.
Okay.
You can walk up there, like underneath the RVs.
Uh-huh. Can you wade in right there? Or is it too deep?
I mean, there's all kinds of ways to do it. You gotta take a look at
it. Yeah, I'll go down there. I got my waders anyways in my truck.
If you have waders on, like right up, like I'm coming down and it's all boulders and rocks in there.
Mm-hmm.
You get down in those things and kind of position yourself in the right spot to cast.
Okay. Okay, yeah, I'll go check it out right now here in a few.
Yeah.
I appreciate it. Beautiful, beautiful spot here. Got the spring running. Like I said, the last time I was here, that wasn't running. But we've been having some nice rain over here. So, looking pretty juicy. I'm gonna try to go down there, but the runoff. I was casting over here, but the trees kept getting in my way, so I'm gonna go this way now. I don't want to bust my butt. I'll just walk around. Somebody over there camping out. Maybe in the spring I'll come and get a camp out spot here and I'll just fish all day. Get my kayak. Bring it with me. And just fish this whole area. They said the guy that runs this spot, he said that they stopped stocking it with trout last Friday, so no more stocking. But that's cool. It was fun while it lasted. But I know that there's still some stock trout running around up and down the river, so there has to be some more somewhere. We just gotta find them. But whatever we catch, we catch. And there's some signs of little bait, I think. Oh yeah. Yeah, I see little pop-ups. I got more room to cast here also. Let me try to cast them to that in there. Oh man, I held it back. There we go. The grass caught up on the He didn't let it run. So we're getting rained out, so I'm about to head on out. We didn't catch nothing, so it was fun just to be out here learning how to do this. I have one for salt water. Maybe I'll use it this summer more late now that I want to get into this. So but yeah, they stopped stocking this portion of the river last Friday, so no wonder nobody was here and I didn't catch anything. But yeah, but thank you for watching. And if you have any pointers, any tips on what I'm doing or anything, let me know. Maybe it'll help me out. The rod I bought was a 5-weight, 9-foot, so I'm able to catch trout, bass, and stuff like that. So let me know. So I'll see you on the next one.